How to stop being broke. How to get rid of your financial problems. How to stop living paycheck to paycheck. Can hardly make ends meet. Do this if you want to get rid of your financial troubles. Do this if you're tired of not having enough money. We will take a look at it in this video. So there you are. Things are hard. You can hardly make ends meet. Inflation is on the rise. We are at a point of hyperinflation. Money keeps losing value. You're worried about it. You went to the grocery store at one time with a certain amount of money. It was able to buy a certain amount of stuff. It no longer can do that. Gas prices, everything is rising. It's gone past inflation to hyperinflation. You don't have enough money. You get paid, and before too long, you're broke again. You don't have enough money again. You can hardly pay your bills. The bank is calling you. You can hardly pay your rent. You're late on your mortgage payments. It's depressing. It's tough. What a challenge. You just don't have enough. Can hardly take care of your family. You don't have enough money to do the things you want to do, to help your loved ones, to support your favorite cause or charity, to do good. It's not enough. Money problems, financial problems, you broke. And very often, it's through no fault of people. You see, the system did not teach you about money. You went to school, they never taught us about money. All they told us was go to school, get good grades, and you will get a good job. The subject of money is so forbidden, even in religious circles. You are taught that money is a bad thing, that if you have less money, if you're poor, God will be happier. And that is a lie. They tell you that money is a bad thing, yet they collect it in church. The way the universe is set up, we need money. Money is only a tool. Money is not a bad thing. Money is only a byproduct of giving value. Money is only a byproduct of success. The more you give, the more you will receive. How do you stop being broke? How do you get more money in that bank account of yours? How do you have enough money to go on vacation when you want, to be lying on the beach drinking coconut water, to have that bigger apartment, to build that house, to build that bigger house, to live in a mansion, to have that Lamborghini, that BMW, that Lexus, that whatever car it is that you want. You see people doing that all the time. Some are millionaires. You go online, you see billionaires. You see people thriving. People making hundreds of thousands, even millions a day. But not you. You there broke. You there working for the boss, making him rich, and not you. They lied to you about a job. You trading hours for dollars. You trading time for money. And since there are only 24 hours in the day, since the time in the day or time is limited, you can never get rich that way. You will continue to be broke. I'm here to let you know that, having said all of this, you need to know that broke, poor, having a little amount of money is only an illusion. You have to see it as the appearance of being broke. The appearance of a lack, there is only abundance. The appearance of poverty, there is only riches. There is only wealth. The way to change your financial situation is to change your mindset. I will say this again. To change your financial situation for the better, you have to change your mindset. Instead of saying, "I am poor," say, "I am rich." Let the poor say, "I am rich." Understand law of attraction. When you are offering a vibration, that vibration can and will be matched. If you don't have enough money, if you're broke, if you're living paycheck to paycheck, it's because you have momentum around being broke. You have momentum around poverty, and it breeds more and more brokenness, more and more poverty. I'm sorry to say, but it means that you have to raise your vibration to one of abundance, to one of wealth. If you don't have enough money, it's because you have thought your way to not enough money. It may be the matrix, the system to blame for never. There are ants everywhere in nature. It may be the system, and it is, they have taught you nothing about money. Because of what they have taught you, it has perpetuated poverty. But it has a lot to do with the way you think. If you think thoughts of lack, you will have more lack. If you're always complaining, you will have more brokenness, if that is a word. You will have more poverty. What is important is to change your mindset to one of abundance, and you shall be abundant. Stop saying things like, "I don't have enough money. I can't pay the bills." Calling somebody on the telephone, "Oh, things are so hard this month." Crying, complaining. Say something else. Speak a different language. You may not have that physical equivalent of the thing you have asked for in your hands, but you have to believe that it is there. Money may not be there on a 3D level in the physical, but you have asked for money, and it is there in what is called vibrational escrow, or what is called the vortex by teachers like Abraham Hicks, one of my favorites. It is there. The money you have asked, the universe has already been created. Ask and it is given. So your first step is to ask. That happens whether you like or not. Because if you're suffering, if you're poor, if you're broke, you're asking. Now, listen to this. You have to get into vibrational alignment with the money you want. You have to become a match for money. And that is the point right there. Become a match for money. To be a match for money, you won't be looking at the rich and saying, oh, they did something bad. Oh, they sold drugs. The only way to make money is to be dishonest. Oh, they're evil. They sold their soul. You're a bad person. And to have money, you must be a bad person. You're saying to the universe that you're not a match for money. Because I know you don't want to be a bad person. You don't want to sell drugs. You don't want to do evil stuff. You don't want to do bad stuff. You don't want to break the law. If you say that, you're not a match for money. You're not in alignment with money. You have to look at people who are doing well and cheer them, be happy for them, clap for them. And it must not be something fake, it must be real. At first, it may be difficult for you, but as you practice, it will become a part of you. Where you're just happy, where you're seeing beauty in everything, where you're seeing the abundance of the universe, where you're looking at the trees, you're seeing abundance. You're looking at the birds, you're seeing abundance. You walk in your neighborhood, you're in the city, you look at things, you see, wow, so much wealth everywhere. There is an abundance of wealth. You have this abundance mindset. Instead of scarcity, you appreciate the things around you. Your words, what follows I am. Be careful what follows I am. I am should be followed by positive words only. I am rich. I am financially free. I am abundant. I am doing well. Say these things daily. Type it in the comments. Type something positive after I am. I am wealthy. I am rich. And you will think to yourself, why type this when I am not wealthy? Yes, you are. You are wealthy. It's just that you have strayed a little. You have strayed from it. You have strayed from it. You have asked the universe. It is already given. You have to see yourself. It is so easy for those who are born into riches, because that is what they know. They know wealth. But a lot of people are self-made. They had to see themselves as successful to become successful. And when you ask, it is given. To get that thing in your hand, you must become a vibrational match for it. Have you seen somebody who won the lottery? They lose all the money. People who won the lottery, they lose all the money very often in the matter of a year, 2 years. And they just won $100 million and more because they are not a match for money. They were able to get the money, but it goes away because of their mindset. They think like a poor person. The difference between rich and poor is the way they think. Understand that it's all about mindset. Understand that it's all about the way you think. You become more of who you are. They never taught you this. They don't want you to know these things. If you know these things, you will become too powerful. You won't be at their mercy. You won't be dependent on them. You won't give away your power to them. They won't be able to control you. So they kept these things away from you. They kept these secrets away from you. Be happy. Be thankful. Appreciate. Raise your vibration to one of love. You see the way they're preaching fear, fear, negative, negative? Raise your vibration to one of contentment. Be happy in order to do things. If you're doing things in order to be happy, you're doing them in the wrong order. When you're happy, when you're feeling good, when you know that poverty is only an illusion, when you know that being broke is only an appearance, you can look at the appearance of poverty and say, no, there is only wealth. You become a match. And the thing you have asked for, the money will be in your hand. And be sure to ask for more. Be sure to ask for a lot. The universe doesn't know the difference between creating a castle or a button. Whatever you ask for, it is given. You need to have that faith. You need to have that belief. Go past belief to knowing. All the great spiritual teachers, whether it be Jesus Christ, whether it be Buddha, whether it be Krishna, you name it, Muhammad, you name it, all of them spoke about the power of your thoughts, the power of asking and receiving, that when you ask, it is given. It is right there in your Bible. Whether you're religious or not, as a spiritual person, take value or take what there, no matter whether you believe in everything Christianity says, there is value in it. Whether you believe in everything the Buddhists say, there is value in some of what they teach. Or whatever religion, whatever denomination, pick out what you love and discard what you do not love or what doesn't work for you. So there is value in what a lot of these spiritual teachers taught. You do not have to throw away the baby with the bath water. So as you live your life, as things begin to come to you, you will meet disappointment. Things may not always work out perfectly. You will meet failures. You will meet challenges. You will meet obstacles. But you have to see them as blessings in disguise. You will reach a point where even your failures, your obstacles, the pain will be seen as blessings, because you know that things are always working out for you. Things always work out for you. I'm telling you, it's a mindset thing. I'm telling you, it's a vibrational thing. Be vibrationally aligned to money. Be vibrationally aligned to wealth, and you will never be broke again. When you align to money, inspired action will be taken. Because of your mindset, because you know that all you do is win, because you know that you're rich, because you know that you're wealthy, it will inspire you to take action, and you will take the right action. If you know that you are a rich person, if you know that you're a millionaire, a multi-millionaire, a billionaire, you will not be lying on your bed the entire day, every day you are at home doing nothing, not starting any new venture, not reading good books, not watching videos that inspire you, not learning. No, you will take action. You will make mistakes, but you will take action. You will access the law of giving and receiving. You will give. You will give so much that you're bound to receive. It is said that if you want to make $1 million, do not focus so much on the $1 million per se. Think of how you can help 1 million people and you will have your $1 million. That is where the law of action comes into place. Remember, it is the vibrational work that you have to focus on, and the action will take care of itself. If you are not taking action, it means that you are not yet a match. You do not know that you are a rich person. Things are not gonna fall from the sky and happen without hands. That is what a lot of people miss when talking about manifestation, when talking about law of attraction. They leave out action, but you have to take action. A lot of people watch the movie The Secret. They watched the movie The Secret and they thought that, oh, they just have to say mantras, make affirmations every day. No, that is important. But if you're not taking action, it means that you're not sold on it. You do not believe what you're saying. You do not see yourself as that advancing man or woman. You must understand that there is nothing anybody has that you cannot have. You need to understand that opportunity is not monopolized. The rich have not taken money and put a fence around it. Get rid of that scarcity mindset to think that they have everything and you cannot have nothing. Have this abundance mindset. Don't think that opportunity is monopolized, or think there is for some people. They are doing well, not you. They can achieve, not you. A lot of people may be looking at you that way, thinking that you will never amount to anything, thinking that you will never make it in life, thinking that you're doomed to failure. But because they think that about you, you're not about to think that about yourself. You know that you shall win. You know that you're a winner. That mindset is what you need. And then the thing you have asked for, which is in vibrational escrow, when you align to it, you will have it in your hand. When it gets in your hand, there may be disappointments, there will be failures along the way, but you see your failures as blessings. You do not feel bad, feel depressed, oh, things will never work out. No, you maintain that high vibration, and when you maintain that high vibration, you will not be broke again. You will not be financially depressed. You will be financially free. You will become rich. You will be a millionaire, a multi-millionaire, whatever you have asked for. If you have the faith like a mustard seed, you will be able to move mountains. That is law of attraction. Law of attraction is always working. Tap into that good energy and you will do well. You will be financially free. There you are on the Manchus Way YouTube channel. I'm sending you loads of positive energy, abundance energy, success energy. May all your desires manifest. May you achieve all the wonderful, delicious things you want to achieve, all the money you want to make. Share the video, like the video, type a comment, spread your light. One love, Jah bless, and all the best.